Green urine can mean what? 5 health conditions your pee color may be trying to warn you about. All right, brace yourselves. Today we're going to have a very important and maybe even awkward or embarrassing conversation about your urine. Details like, why do we pee? What color should your urine be? And how many times you should be running to the restroom every day? You definitely will be shocked when you hear some of these colorful details. Hey everyone, I'm Dr. Jordan Wagner. I'm an emergency room doctor who treats everything from COVID to gunshot wounds, burns, you name it. I've created this video series to help answer some of your medical questions and the questions I get from patients each and every day. If you find this video helpful, please do me a favor and subscribe. All right, let's dive right in. What you may or may not realize is that having a healthy bladder and a urinary tract is an important part of being a healthy human, any species for that matter. In other words, peeing, although maybe not a topic you want to discuss loosely in front of just anyone, it is important to understand why we urinate and why is it so important for your body's natural processes and for maintaining a healthy lifestyle. That's also why today we're going to go over 5 things your pee color can tell you about your health. It can seriously be detrimental. But before we get into our list, it's important to know why in the world we urinate in the first place. The body produces pee as a way of getting rid of waste that the body doesn't need and extra fluids such as excess water. Most people may not realize that before leaving the body, urine travels through the urinary tract, which first starts at the kidneys. In other words, one of the kidney's most important roles in the body is to filter waste out of the blood and to make your urine. Yes, the kidneys make urine. And then from there, urine travels down through the ureters into the bladder and out through the urethra when it's time to do so. But here's the kicker. How one produces pee is only half of the discussion. The color of your urine is also a big part of your urinary tract health. In fact, when the color of your urine is abnormal or things say burn in regions they shouldn't, that's when people and patients usually have to come see doctors like me in the emergency room or urologists who really specialize in this topic. In general, your pee should be a light yellow color because urine is a mix of excess water, waste, and other things like electrolytes, as I mentioned before, gets filtered out of your bloodstream. So it's totally normal for the color of your urine to somewhat vary from day to day a little. This could mean it goes from almost colorless some days to maybe more of a honey color the next, really depending on the amount of fluid you're consuming. When you are healthy and hydrated, your urine should really sort of fall into the light yellow category. But when things take a dramatic and colorful turn, or when your pee starts to resemble the colors of the rainbow, this could be a sign of possible dangers to your health. So what can your pee color tell you about your health? Here are 5 things you need to know ASAP. Number 1, your urine is pink to reddish in color. If you haven't recently eaten something like a beet or some other brightly colored fruit or food that tends to have dramatic effects on your urine color, Houston, we may have a problem. For instance, pink or reddish colored urine could be a sign of blood. Yes, blood in your urine or kidney disease, which basically means your kidneys aren't working properly. High blood pressure or diabetes can cause chronic kidney disease. But there are other reasons your urine may be pink to reddish in color. Kidney stones, urinary tract infections, prostate problems, cancer, and even lead or mercury poisoning can change the color of your urine. So if your urine goes from a normal color to this bright reddish or pink hue and doesn't return to normal in a short period of time, definitely contact your doctor as soon as possible. Number 2, amber or honey colored pee. If your urine color is anything darker than the light yellow range that we discussed earlier, your body is trying to send you a bit of a signal and maybe a warning signal here that the darker your urine is, it is typically a sign that your body is a bit dehydrated and that you need to drink some more water in order to get it back to the normal range of hydration. This can sometimes happen also if you have been outside sweating a lot on a hot day or maybe even because you just finished a heavy workout. Don't completely freak out if it changes. It's all about having a normal range of color. But this darker amber or honey color shouldn't last more than a day or two if you're keeping yourself hydrated within a normal range. This color could also be a sign of rhabdomyolysis, meaning you just crushed a workout, but you had too much muscle breakdown and your kidneys are processing myoglobin, which is then spilling into your urine. Number three, dark brown or syrup colored urine. Now, if your pee color turns even darker toward the syrup side of the spectrum, you should get fluids in your body as soon as possible. This means your body's dehydration level is crossing a line into the danger zone. Start really pounding the water. Pee that is dark brown in color could also be caused by bilirubin getting into your urine, which is a sign of liver disease. In some rare instances, darker urine could be caused by porphyria, a rare issue that affects the skin and nervous system. If your urine does not lighten up by rehydrating, you need to see a doctor right away. Number four, blue or greenish urine. Yes, it could happen. Blue or green urine could show up in the toilet one day. Typically, it's caused by something you ate. Think weird fruit punch or birthday cake frosting with heavy food dyes, etc. But sometimes your urine can also change a radical shade to blue or green because of other reasons like a bacteria infection in the urinary tract or medications could be the culprit. And sometimes even rare genetic diseases like hypercalcemia, where excessive calcium levels build up in your blood, could be to blame. If you continue to see unusually blue or green colored urine, definitely contact your doctor. All right, number five, orange pee. If your urine looks like you just drank a glass of Sunny Delight, this may be a sign that something else is going on. Now, as I mentioned before, of course, it could be a byproduct of something more mundane, like a food dye making its way out of your urethra. But orange colored pee could also be caused by certain medications. For instance, if you have a urinary tract infection, sometimes medications will contain ingredients that can temporarily change your urine to a more orange color, think pyridium. But if you do not have a UTI or not on any medications, you can also have something more serious going on down there, like a liver or bile duct condition. If you're getting plenty of fluids and staying hydrated and this urine color doesn't go away, guess what? Go reach out to see your doctor. Also, keep in mind, if your urine is completely colorless or basically transparent, you may be getting too many fluids, so consider backing off just a tad. It's all about staying hydrated and staying close to that light yellow color. All right, time for the true golden question. How many times should you be peeing in a day? Maybe you think you have an overactive bladder, or maybe you can go all day without having to use the bathroom even once, which I don't recommend. But generally speaking, how often you urinate depends on how quickly your kidneys produce the urine that fills the bladder and really how much your bladder can comfortably hold. Typically, it is considered normal to have to urinate about 6 to 8 times in a 24-hour period of time. Now, keeping in mind, if you are going more often than that, it could mean that you're drinking too much fluid or maybe consuming too much caffeine or other diuretics that flush liquids out of your body quicker. The amount of urine produced in one's body depends on many other factors. Things like food and drink consumption and the amount of fluid you lose through things like sweating or breathing, these details all come into play. Also, certain medications and or medical conditions can increase or decrease the amount of urine your body produces as well. Age can affect things too. For instance, children typically produce less urine than adults. And on the other side of the coin, often as you age, your bladder muscles and other things like the prostate may be impacted over time, causing you to feel like you need to urinate more frequently. All right, that's been a quick, colorful pee breakdown with me, Dr. Wagner. Do you have any other questions about urination? Like, should it smell? Should it be foggy? Should it bubble or fizz? And want me to make another follow-up pee video? Let me know in the comments. Also, do you have any other medical topics like this that can be a little embarrassing that you want me to break down? Let me know that too in the comments. Okay, please make sure you subscribe and turn your bell notifications on. When you do that and you hit that like button, you let YouTube know that you'd like to see more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching and stay healthy, my friends.